I go in here or did I come from here? Hello?
Monsters coming back. Mechs will protect. Safe from swarms. Have to hide.
Monsters?
No monsters. No swarms. No.
No.
Vitor?
No, Vitor. Not here. Swarms can't find. Monsters coming. Have to hide.
Just snap out of it, man.
Hey, I'm talking to you.
Great. We come all this way and our only witness is a babbling idiot.
Huh.
Swarm's coming. Storm coming. Storm of swarms. Mechs will protect. Have to hide. No escape.
Sure.
Can't hide forever. Swarms will find you. Monsters find you. No hope. No escape.
Renegade action. I thought I pressed it already.
You're not one of them. You're human. They didn't find you?
How can you tell underneath this armor, though?
The monsters. The swarms. They took everyone.
Tell us what happened.
Why didn't the colonists fight back, Vitor? What happened?
You don't know. You didn't see. But I see everything.
Looks like security footage. He must have pieced it together manually.
What the hell is that?
My god. I think it's a collector.
What the hell is a collector?
Is that some kind of alien?
They're a species from somewhere beyond the Omega 4 relay. Only a few people have ever seen one in person.
Really?
They usually work through intermediaries, like slavers or hired mercenaries. If they're involved with the Reapers somehow, it could explain what happened to the colonies.
That's them?
The collectors have advanced technology. They could have a weapon that disables an entire settlement at once.
What do
the
they
seeker
collect?
Swarms. No one can hide.
Oh.
The seekers find you, freeze you, then the monsters take you away.
They freeze you. Swarms.
Tell me more about these swarms.
It's how they find you. Seeker clouds, machines like tiny insects. They go everywhere. They find you, then they sting you, freeze you.
Sounds like miniature probes, maybe. Find victims, then immobilize them with a stasis field or nerve toxin.
Okay, so they paralyze you. They literally freeze you. I'm thinking someone frozen solid. What can you tell me about the collectors?
I want to know more about the collectors.
Yeah, who
nobody knows much. They're so rare, a lot of people don't even believe they exist.
More importantly, why are they abducting human colonists? What are they after?
Maybe the Illusive Man can figure it out.
Hmm. Obviously they're collecting the colonists, but to what purpose? We help you escape, Vitor?
Why didn't the collectors take you?
Swarms didn't find me.
Oh, you did escape.
Monsters didn't know I was here.
The collectors aren't known for being careless. Maybe his enviro suit kept him from showing up on their sensors.
Or they were using technology specifically designed to detect humans. Only human colonies have been hit.
Oh, interesting. Yeah, that could be. Well, go on, Vitor, with your story.
What happened next?
The monsters took the people onto the ship, and then they left. The ship flew away. But they'll be back for me. No one escapes.
I think that's probably all we're getting out of him, Commander.
Hmm. Well, thank you, Vitor.
We appreciate what you told us. You were very helpful.
I studied them. The monsters. The swarms. I recorded them with my Omni tool. Lots of readings. Electromagnetic. Dark energy.
We need to get this data to the Illusive Man. Grab the quarry and call the shuttle to come pick us up.
Dark energy.
Vitor is injured. He needs treatment, not an interrogation.
How about
we
both?
Won't hurt him. We just need to see if he knows anything else. He'll be returned unharmed.
Your people tried to betray us once already. If we give him to you, we'll never get the intel we need.
Praza was an idiot, and he and his men paid for it. You're welcome to take Vitor's Omnitool data, but please, just let me take him.
Well, you know, we have a medical facility. I was freaking dead. They brought me back to life. They should be able to heal him. You should join us, Tally.
You don't have to take Vitor and go. We could work together, just like old times.
I'm still trying to accept that you're even alive. and you're with Cerberus. I've got responsibilities now. I've got a mission of my own. I can't walk away from that.
Aww.
Not even for you.
I don't really think he can tell us much more. I don't know. This is a tough decision. Well, not that anyone in this room has to know the basis of my decision, but because of me and Tali's friendship, I will let Vitor go with him. Just, yeah, we'll take his Omni-tool.
He's traumatized and he needs medical care. Tali will give us the Omni-tool data and take him to the flotilla.
Understood, Commander.
Thank you, Shepard. I'm glad you're still the one giving the orders. Good luck out there. If I find anything that can help you, I'll let you know.
We're ready for pickup.
Shepard, good work on Freedom's Progress. The Quarians forwarded their findings from Vitor's debriefing. No new data, but it's a surprising olive branch given our history. You and I have different methods, but I can't argue with your results.
Well, having friends pays off.
You ever think about playing nice once in a while?
Diplomacy is great when it works, but difficult when everyone already perceives you as a threat. But more importantly, you confirm the Collectors are behind the abductions.
Who are they?
Tell me what you know about these Collectors.
They periodically travel to the Terminus systems, looking to gather seemingly unimportant items or specimens, usually in exchange for their technology. When their transactions are complete, they disappear as quickly as they arrived, back beyond the unmapped Omega 4 relay. Until now, we've had no evidence of direct aggression by the Collectors.
What is the nature of these transactions?
What are the Collectors getting from these deals?
The Collectors aren't very forthcoming about their motives. Generally, they seek out species with rare genetic mutations or abnormalities.
Really?
They pay slavers and merc groups exorbitant sums to obtain these specimens, and then they leave. But they've never targeted a single species before, and the previous sample sizes were in the dozens, not the tens of thousands.
Huh, they're studying mutation? Is it possibly to help themselves? Maybe they're mutating. I'm just musing here, guys. Don't tell me if I'm right or wrong. It's just interesting to think about. And we haven't seen any of these colonists. I wonder if a lot of them were mutated. Well, they're interested in humans.
Any ideas on why they've shifted their focus to humans?
If they're agents for the Reapers, it could be any number of reasons. Obviously, humanity played a huge role in Sovereign's destruction. That might have been enough to draw their attention. What really concerns me is why they bother abducting the colonists. Once the humans are paralyzed, why not just kill them?
Well, they obviously want to study them. Especially if they're looking for the source and what the nature of these mutations are. What about this Omega 4 relay?
Why is the Omega 4 relay unmapped? What do we know about it?
Only that no ship passing through it has ever returned. Our best guess is that the relay reacts differently to Collector vessels, allowing them safe passage. If they can manipulate relays, that's just further evidence of the connection with the Reapers.
Yeah, possibly, because everyone else knows how to use them, doesn't know how to even reverse engineer them, not on that scale. I mean, the Protheans made a small relay. So what aren't you telling me, exactly? Because I know there's more.
You're holding something back. How do you know the Reapers are involved?
The patterns are there, buried in the data. The Consul and the Alliance want to believe the Reaper threat died with Sovereign. You and I know better. I won't wait until the Reapers are on the march. We need to take the fight to them.
Well, I can't do it alone.
If this is a war, I'll need an army, or a really good team.
I've already compiled a list of soldiers, scientists, and mercenaries. You'll get dossiers on the best of them. Finding them and convincing them to work with you could be challenging, but you're a natural leader. I'll continue to track the Collectors. When they make their next appearance, I'll notify you and your team. Be ready.
Well, you know, I had a good team.
Keep your list. I want people I trust. The ones who helped me stop Saren and the Geth.
That was 2 years ago, Commander. Most of them have moved on, or their allegiances have changed.
Liara.
Where's Liara Tassoni?
She's on Ilium. My sources say that she's working for the Shadow Broker. If so, she can't be trusted.
Really? For the Shadow Broker? I just want to see if he says something different.
Where's Liara Tassoni?
She's on Ilium.
Alright.
My sources say
Tally?
She's working for the Shadow Broker. If so, she can't be trusted.
What about Tally? She already helped us on Freedom's Progress.
That was unexpected. I need more intel before I'll commit to that.
Rex?
Where's Erdnot Rex?
He returned to Chichanka, and he hasn't gone off-world in over a year. He's trying to unite the Krogan clans.
Oh, really? Well, good for Rex. That's pretty impressive. And Ashley?
Where's Ashley Williams?
She's still with the Alliance. Promoted, I believe. Her file is surprisingly well classified.
Really? And Garrus?
Where's Garrus Vakarian?
The Turian disappeared a few months after you were declared dead. Even we haven't been able to locate him.
Oh, he's gone into deep cover.
Okay, I get it. They're not available.
You're a leader, Shepard. You'll get who you need.
I'm a Spectre.
I'm still a Spectre. Maybe I can get the Council to help us out.
If you think you could convince them, by all means. Just remember, you've been gone a long time. Things have changed.
We'll be ready.
You worry about the collectors. I'll make sure my team's ready.
Good. Two things before you go.
Cancer Man.
First, head to Omega and find Morden Solas.
Morden?
He's a brilliant Solarian scientist.
Omega.
Our intelligence suggests he may know how to counteract the Collector's paralyzing Seeker Swarms.
Huh. Is that an order?
I haven't even started and you're telling me what to do?
I'm giving you direction. What you do with it is up to you. I'm sure you'll make the right decision.
All right. What's the other thing?
I found a pilot I think you might like. I hear he's one of the best.
Someone Joker?
You can trust.
Joker?
Hey, Commander. Just like old times, huh?
I can't believe it's you, Joker.
Look who's talking. I saw you get spaced.
Got lucky, with a lot of strings attached. How'd you get here?
It all fell apart without you, Commander. Everything you stirred up, the Council just wanted it gone. The team was broken up, record sealed, and I was grounded. The Alliance took away the one thing that mattered to me. Hell yeah, I joined Cerberus.
You really trust the Illusive Man?
Well, I don't trust anyone who makes more than I do. But they aren't all bad. Saved your life, let me fly, and there's this. They only told me last night.
Ooh! SR2. Nice. It looks a lot like the Normandy. Only brand sparkling new.
It's good to be home, huh, Commander?
I guess we'll have to give her a name.
Well, we're a lot more happy to see Joker than Tally. What the hell's up with that? The Normandy. The Normandy Mark II. Version 2.0. Yay! Awesome. See? You really can go home again. That was cool as hell. Really enjoyed that little scene. And running into Tally and Joker. Collectors confirmed a source of attacks on Freedom's Progress. Quarian survivor Vitor returned with Talizora to the migrant fleet. We'll examine his Omnitool data for anything useful. You must recruit a head scientist to build this upgrade. Yeah, I thought I saw something about that. Plus 15% heavy. Now, I need to be able to see her face. I don't want to be looking at her freaking helmet the entire game. The power cell technology used by heavy weapons is fairly old, but can be improved by rebuilding the core with more modern components. These improvements allow standard power cells to yield more shots per power cell and allow for more total shots to be fired. Oh, so I'm getting funding. I'm getting credits to these guys. So they gave me 10,000. I find that 9,000 bonus. I found 2,000 iridium. So really, really curious. Really interested to see where this goes. We gotta round up the old crew. Just have to. Press M and left ship. Objective marker. Yeah, I know about that. Nice! The theme! Well, I can see her face. That's great.
Welcome aboard the new Normandy, Commander.
Welcome aboard yourself. It's my ship.
I've been looking over the dossiers. I'd strongly recommend starting by acquiring Morden Solus, the Solarian professor on Omega. We know the Collectors use some type of advanced technology to immobilize their victims. We'll need him to develop a countermeasure to protect us.
By the way, this is my ship.
You still don't get it, do you? You're not in charge of this mission. I am.
Operative Lawson makes a valid point, Shepard. Without the Professor, any encounter with the Collectors would result in failure.
Who's this?
Who are you?
I am the Normandy's artificial intelligence. The crew like to refer to me as Edie.
Oh my god. Joker is not gonna like this.
Helmsmen aren't happy when someone takes control of a ship away from them. Especially Joker.
I do not helm the ship. Mr. Moreau's talents will not go to waste. During combat, I operate the electronic warfare and cyber warfare suites. Beyond that, I cannot interface with the ship's systems. I observe and offer analysis and advice. Nothing more.
Huh. Anyone else I should meet?
I'm guessing it takes more than just the three of us plus Joker to fly this ship.
The Normandy has a full crew. They're at their stations awaiting your orders.
I see them.
Final preparations for takeoff are complete, Commander. When you're ready to go, just pick a destination from the galaxy map and the CIC and I'll plot a course.
Jacob and I should return to our posts. Come find us if you have any questions.
Right. I know what to do with the galaxy map. Thank you very much. Private terminal to get status update. Okay. Weapons from the armory. Okay. How do I go past this? Right. Elevator. Makes sense. Customize my appearance. Okay. Tech lab. Acquire the professor to research. Okay. Upgrade a few squads of equipment. Using the Illusive Man's dossiers, assemble a team of experts.
Welcome aboard, Commander.
Collectors. Thank you. Yeoman Chambers.
I'm Yeoman Kelly Chambers.
Well, she's pretty.
I've been assigned as your administrative assistant. I'll manage your messages and help you monitor the crew. And I must say, it's such an honor to work under you, Commander Shepard.
The pleasure is mine.
I'm glad to have you on the team, Miss Chambers.
Please, call me Kelly.
Sure.
Okay, Kelly.
Anything else?
How's the crew?
Is there anything I should know?
You have unread messages at your private terminal. Joker would like to speak to you on the bridge. Anything else, Commander?
Okay, I really didn't ask her how's the crew.
Do you have a moment to talk?
Chat?
I always have time for you, Commander.
Uh-huh. What do you do?
What are your responsibilities?
I'll keep you notified of any messages or appointments you might have. If any of the crew has important business to discuss, I'll make sure you know.
So in other words, you're my secretary, is that all?
Isn't that the type of task better suited for a VI?
Yes, but being your yeoman is just my official role. Unofficially, I observe the crew. Everyone knows how risky our mission is. Many of us may not be coming back. That's a lot of pressure. I have a degree in psychology. I'm good at sensing when people are overly taxed.
You're a counselor?
You make sure the crew's mental health is sound.
Yes. I look for warning signs. I listen. It's not a full-time job, and it's most effective when done informally.
Well, it's good you're here.
We're lucky to have someone with your skills, Kelly.
Thank you, Shepard. What else would you like to know?
Yours skills? What do you think of Cerberus?
This organization has a dark reputation. Do you have any concerns working for them?
Not at all. Our methods can be harsh, but Cerberus has noble objectives. We look out for human interests. Advance human technology, save human lives. They're good goals.
Does Cerberus hate aliens? That's an interesting phrased question.
It sounds like Cerberus wants to dominate all aliens and put humankind on top.
Cerberus looks out for humanity, but that doesn't mean we hate aliens. My sister started a dog shelter, but she loved cats too. I love humanity. I also love Asari, Quarian, Turian, Salarian, Hanar. That isn't in conflict with Cerberus ideals.
Okay. You're naive, you're very loving. Neither. Are you happy here?
How do you feel about being assigned to the Normandy?
I was handpicked by the Illusive Man to help fight the greatest threat known to humanity. How do I feel? Honored, exhilarated, terrified. But mostly I feel encouraged. Under your leadership, we can't fail.
We won't.
Don't worry. We'll defeat the Collectors.
I trust you implicitly. The moment I met you, I knew I could close my eyes, fall back, and you'd be there.
I'd embrace you? Oh boy, so we got a love interest already. I'd drop you. I'll catch you, right?
Your trust is well placed, Kelly.
I knew it would be. Thank you, Shepard. Anything else you'd like to talk about?
Nope.
I better go.
Okay. Maybe we'll talk later.
Oh, that's the Normandy crash site DLC that just popped up there. Oh, and Project Firewalker. That's the Firewalker pack. Service labor. Paragon action. Okay. I just walk around, look at everything, and talk to anybody. Private terminal? Where's the private terminal? Back here? Archangel? Who are we looking at? Somebody... Oh! These are dossiers, and these are two people we know. Archangel, small unit tactical expertise, omni-tool expert, and noted sniper. Archangel is a mercenary commander whose operations are noted for their technical expertise and strategic brilliance. He is responsible for high-profile attacks on gang leaders on Omega and can likely be found there. Loyalty is normal. This is the one we looked at? Yeah. These are all crew members? Oh, not crew members. Oh, squads? Okay, I guess Solus can be a squad member. The professor, Dr. Morden Solis. Biological weapons expert, light weapons training with the Solarian Special Task Group. Oh cool, he's a Solarian. Dr. Morden Solis is a Solarian biological weapons expert whose technology may hold the key to countering Collector attacks. He is currently operating a medical clinic in the slums of Omega. Hmm. Oh, so I can't look at these yet. Alright. Dossier the Warlord. There was a Warlord base we couldn't get to in the first game, at the end of the first game, because I didn't have enough Renegade points. I wonder if it's the same Warlord. Dr. O'Keer, millennia of combat and strategic experience, rumored familiarity with Collector technology. A brilliant, brutal Krogan warlord and Krogan Rebellion's veteran, O'Keer is obsessed with saving the Krogan from the Genophage. It appears he contracted the Collectors to gain the necessary technology. Currently at a Blue Sun's camp on Corlys, his relationship with the mercenaries is unknown. The convict, Jack. No last name known. Exceptional biotic ability. Note, criminal background, currently in custody. Jack is rumored to be the most powerful human biotic. Wow. Little else is known, but the subject has a history of violence and should be approached carefully. Currently, Jack is being held on the Turian prison ship Purgatory. Cerberus has negotiated for the subject's release. Alright, so definitely a roguish character there. The Master Thief, Kasumi. Oh, one of the DLCs is, like, partially named after him. Kasumi... What was it called? Stolen Memory. Sabotage, infiltration, extraction, property acquisition, stealth, agile combat. This subject has stolen extremely valuable resources from Cerberus in the past. Alarm systems, DNA encoders, guards, and various other deterrents were bypassed, and we don't know how. Oh, she was last seen on the Citadel. Okay, female. Female Kasumi. Upgrades. Review your upgrades. Improve squad members' powers, your weapons, and your ship, making mission success more likely. Acquire new upgrades by finding them on missions, purchasing them from stores, or research them using a research terminal. Well, I guess I don't have any upgrades. Unread messages. Oh my. Oh, Counselor Anderson. On the off chance that the rumors are true and you actually are alive, I need you to come and talk to me on the Citadel. A lot has changed in the last 2 years. You put us on top, and it's only fair that you be allowed to speak for yourself about what we've been hearing. Oh. Awesome. Lost contact with survey ship from Project Firewalker. Commander, the MSV Rosalie, a survey ship with Cerberus connections, has gone missing. The survey team was field testing a new prototype, the Hammerhead Planetside Exploration Rover. That's from the DLC. In addition, scientists Dr. Manuel Case and Dr. Robert O'Loy are aboard the MSV Rosalie and conducting research for us. We need you to find the ship, her survey team, and the doctors. The MSV Rosalie was last seen near planet Ziona, Elista, Ismar Frontier. Normandy Crash Site DLC from Admiral Hackett. Commander Shepard, our scans in the Armada system have turned up something we thought you never see, the final location of the wreckage of the SSV Normandy. Alright. So this is the planet we were heading towards when we were flying in space. We thought this news might be important to you, but we also have an ulterior motive. The Alliance would like to honor the Normandy with a monument to be built on the site of the ship's final resting place. We'd like to invite you to place the monument and be the first to walk on the site. Oh. That's very nice of them. There are still 20 crew members unaccounted for from the attack on the Normandy. Really? If you find any signs of these lost crewmen, we ask that you report to the Alliance so that these heroes' families might find some closure. Godspeed to you, Commander. Imagine if we find them alive, though. That'd be the best closure ever. From Illusive Man, Shepard, our armor technicians heard you were back in armor action, sorry, and insisted you should be properly equipped. They put together a package I had delivered to the Normandy. You'll find it in your personal quarters. Fortunately, we know your size. Terminus armor. Our armor technicians found a high-performance suit for you that was manufactured in Terminus systems. That is to say, it isn't exactly legal in Citadel space. It's been delivered to your quarters, so you can try it on. Hope you like the color. That's the armor we've been wearing, so, yeah. Late with that message, Illusive Man. Collector rifle and armor. Our researchers have been working with captured collector technology for some time now. They've developed an experimental armor suit in your size and an assault rifle that the techs say should take a standard thermal clip. I had the items delivered to the Normandy's armory. Good hunting, Umbra Visor. I've had a night vision device delivered to the Normandy. The techs say it helps put biotic and omni-tool attacks on target, and rather than listen to their explanation of how I just sent it your way, it will be in your quarters. And Recon Hood. It occurred to our armor technicians that you may not want to show your face everywhere you go. Well, I've been missing my face, actually. They sent by a hood that Cerberus issues to its covert operatives. It has additional microframe functions that you may like. The hood is in your quarters. Now, this stuff here, this was all free with the Cerberus code. Key, the account key that I got. So, free, so might as well redeem it. Is there more? Oh, there's more. Crap. More DLC stuff. That's where it all is, I guess, here. Sentry Interface Visor. Our software experts looked over your loadout telemetry and they had a recommendation. A visor with onboard processors that manages your armor's shield strength. I've sent the visor to the Normandy. It'll be in your quarters. Blood Dragon Armor, yeah, DLC. Jacob tells me you've been keeping an eye out for cutting-edge supplies, weapons, armor, amps, and so forth. Sorry, it so happens I had something waiting for you when you awoke in the Lazarus Research Station. It was lost in the chaos, but found again when Cerberus secured the station. I had it delivered to the Normandy. Look in the armor closets in your quarters. It'll be hard to miss. And I have to sneeze. Alright. Sneezing done. Overlord. One of our cells just went off the grid without explanation. Project Overlord has been experimenting with highly volatile technology, and I need you to investigate. Their work is extremely compartmentalized enough that I can't divulge operational details over this channel. You'll find them on the planet Ait, Typhon system in the Phoenix Massing Cluster. Please use care in this matter. Arc Projector. Why, Illusive Man, you've been busy. We recently had an incident involving the Geth at one of our outposts in the Skillian Verge. Don't worry, I'm not sending you off to chase anything down. Our operatives waged a highly successful battle against a Geth scouting party and credited their success to a new advanced electrical attack device that we finally let them take out of the lab. Since their unit is being reassigned for some rest and relaxation, I thought you should take custody of the weapon in the meantime. The weapon is called an arc projector. I sent it to the Normandy's armory so you examine it for yourself and use it if you deem it worthy. It's gone through plenty of tests that indicate it overloads kinetic barriers and synthetic enemies particularly well, but laboratory demonstrations are a poor substitute for actual field reports. We know it works. Now we want to see what it can do in the right hands. If all goes well, we'll use your tactics to train other operatives. Rendezvous with Kasimi Goto. At great cost and effort, we have tracked down the master thief Kasumi Goto and convinced her to work with you. Very few people have even heard of her, and fewer can claim to have seen her in person. She is unequaled at stealth and infiltration, and her skills will prove invaluable in your mission. Travel to the Zakara Ward on the Citadel. There you will find a special air terminal that differs from the usual. Input the password, silence is golden, to begin the rendezvous. Really? Alright. Archived messages. Read your archived messages. Oh, okay, so it goes in there if I mark it as red. Thank you. So it's all in here. Advanced combat training. Watch Cerberus training videos on advanced combat tactics. Watch a training video on tactical use of pausing during combat. How the hell do you guys pause during combat? That's a great...
For increased tactical control,
thing.
Hold left shift to bring up the power wheel. This pauses the action, giving you time to evaluate the battlefield, target new enemies, or select a power. While an enemy is targeted, highlight a power with the mouse, and then press the left mouse button. You can order each squad member to use a power, allowing you to fire up to 3 powers at once. Hmm. The powers will activate when you release left shift and return to real time.
So unrealistic, Tom. Powers. Personal and squad power usage.
After using a power, squad members must wait for their powers to recharge, as indicated by the power status light. On the power wheel, recharging powers are gray, while powers that are currently unnecessary or ineffective against your target are red. Ammunition powers like cryo or incendiary ammo set weapons to enhanced modes. Unity revives fallen squad members, but requires metagel to use.
Okay.
Many attack powers are guided and can be aimed to hit enemies from specific angles and even around corners.
Real-time control. Using powers and issuing squad commands in real time.
To use powers in real time, drag and drop them to the HUD and assign them to the number keys. You can map your squad members' powers in the same way. Press Q and E to order your henchmen to attack, move to cover, or take a position. Hitting C while in this mode will rally your squad members to you. For maximum tactical effectiveness, use squad member powers and your own in combination.
Okay. Well, okay. We're gonna do more looking around. Gonna basically talk to everybody, and in this case, everything. Except for this Kelly, I've already talked to. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And Endure. Ooh, shadows. Yes, he looks spooky. In enduring, grow strong.